Hi, I'm Bina Leras.
Hi, I'm Todd Leras.
Hi, I'm Nick Leras. Welcome to Leras Family Vineyards. Hello, I'm Nick Leras, and you're sitting in Leras Family Vineyards. My dad bought this ranch in 1918, and that's how Leras Family became in the Rush River, Sonoma County area. Was not my choice, but it was a wonderful choice. And when he bought this ranch, there was grapes on it, and prunes and a few apples and cows, and so he was just a regular Greek farmer. And in 1978 we planted our first vineyard on this ranch, commercial vineyard I should say, and got rid of all the other animals and became a vineyard. And we've been producing wine grapes since 1978 on this ranch. And in 1992 we planted our first Pinot Noir here, which is the Pommard clone that's behind us, and that goes into Papa Petro Perry's Pommard and in the Leras Family Vineyard Designate. And we have five different clones here. We have 115, 777, 828, Pommard, and 667. And about 85% of the grapes that you see hanging in the vines where we're sitting go to Papa Petro Perry, and we've been selling to them. This will be the 21st vintage.
If you hear some booms in the background, that's because we have air cannons set up various places in the vineyard to keep the birds who love the grapes from eating them right now as they're getting ready to be ripened and then picked.
I'd like to add to that the noise you hear in the back is cannons, and the noise is to scare the birds off. And our theory of doing this is to be able to save the berries so that we can go in this wonderful wines. And it also is not harmful to the birds. It's part of our sustainable farming that we don't harm the birds and whatever wildlife may come through. We try to disturb them so they don't eat the crop, but we will not harm them. As we sit here, the history of this ranch is very great. We have 32 grandchildren and 16 great-grandchildren and 9 children. So the history is very great here, and it's going to continue having grapes for Leras Family for the next generation, which is sitting next to us. And behind us you will see the barn, the old barn that was here when my dad bought the ranch, and it was about ready to fall. And about 8 years ago we took in the winter time, my guys took it apart. And we took it apart board by board, marked it, and put every board back where it was, and put new foundation under it, new framing. So we kind of restored it to keep our history together.
I had the pleasure of growing up here on this property and playing here with my cousins and friends. And it was quite different when I was a boy than it is now. There were no vineyards here then. This where we're sitting would have been part of a pasture that had sheep, goats, there were cows here, ducks, there was a big duck pond. It's quite a bit different than it was when I was a boy, but much better. And that's all attributable to the hard work of Dad and Vina and putting this vineyard here and caring with it, or for it with love every day.
I married into this beautiful place. My husband is a hard worker and he works out in the vineyard every day. He takes all the love of these grapes as if they were humans. So that's what it's produced such a beautiful wine for Ben.
And like I say, this ranch has been in our family for 104 years. And that's a bit of legacy that I know that Todd's capable of carrying on. You know, I know the struggles my dad had to keep this ranch. You know, we were out here during World War II and it was tough. You know, we had to pick prunes to keep food on the table. You know, there was just no money. You weren't allowed to sell your chickens or anything, you know. So my dad was having a struggle of a time. So my mother and four of us went out and harvested prunes just to have dinner on the table. I mean, we had plenty of chicken, you know, you had to have a loaf of bread, you had to have wheat, you had to have flour, you know, so there's a lot of legacy and he's been around here 58 years that he run around here, and he saw what we had to do to keep this together, and I'm positive that 58 years from now it'll still be this same old ranch. You know, it's easy to sell it. You know, I could just sell it, but I don't want to. It's not mine. This belongs to my mother and father. You know, and the same down below. I could sell it and live good, but I want. I just don't think that anybody's ever gonna manufacture dirt again, ever. Nobody's gonna be smart enough to make dirt. And you're standing on dirt now, keep it, and you'll have something to eat the rest of your life.